I'm Mason Mount. You're listening to the London is Blue podcast.
All right, so jumping right back into it, Norwich looked very dangerous in the first half, especially on the back of two goals. Lampard showed some managerial finesse to find some ways to cancel the Pukki party in the second half. So let's talk about how he did this. I'd like to kick this off with a tweet from a contributor, Nisar Kinsella. Says, big improvement on last week. Much better game management in the second half. Not conceding in a second half of football is a big bonus. Guest of the show, Naz, would you like to comment and elaborate on this statement?
That was a really good tweet by whoever that was, but yeah.
<Really good.
laughs> No, it's a really important thing because I think that's what Frank Lampard has been looking for. You know, you hear it in the press conferences and stuff after the game or before the game. And yeah, you know, this pressing system Chelsea using is very high intensity. They're going to play three games in a week soon. So they need to know that they can manage a game. The great teams, the difference between a great team and a promising team is one that manages a result, manages the emotions that you feel during a football match, you know, setbacks of a goal against a run of play and stuff like that. So the way Chelsea played in the second half was great. They kept possession much better than they did against any of the other teams they faced this season. They didn't go gung-ho. They didn't panic. There was a patience about them. They believed in their quality just to break them down eventually. And Frank Lampard was talking as well that at halftime, he just said, you know, just carry on what you're doing. And the reason they did so well was that, you know, the spine of the team were really solid. They were winning the ball back from the Norwich players very quickly. And they were, you know, just recycling the ball, keeping possession. I didn't feel like Chelsea were under that much danger. Of course, Ben Godfrey hit the bar from a set piece, and there's going to be those kind of things. Chelsea need to improve on set pieces and stuff like that. But really, it would have been a sort of travesty if they lost the game after that second half. They were actually better in the second half than the first half, and that's just because, you know, they can keep pointing to bad luck, you know, playing well and not getting the results, but really that's where games are won, when you just control the game. You're looking at Man City, you're looking at the top teams, that's what they all do, and they stop the other team going down the other end and causing a threat, and exactly what Chelsea did, and I think that they'll be delighted with that, and for a young team to do that as well, it means a lot.
You know,
yeah, I think go ahead, Brandon.
Oh, well, I was just going to tee you up, honestly. I mean, because it got to the point where I think Norwich changed as well. They must have gotten into halftime and say, hey, 2-2. Like, we're in a good situation. Yeah. But, I mean, like I said, there's multiple times in the second half, Dan, where Norwich had every single player behind the ball. They were defending in a block 10, essentially. And then they would clear it. We'd gain possession and then just go right back at them.
Well, what I really like seeing is that the defensive line actually was moving more as a unit in this match. So you saw Christensen, Zuma, Azpilicueta, and Emerson all getting forward in that second half. And, you know, we saw in the first half, you know, the Christensen tried to, you know, play the offside, was caught a little off of the right area to be, plays one of the Norwich players onside, which kind of helps contribute to that goal. In the second half, the solidity of that defensive line pushed forward a little bit more appropriately, managed to stay flat, and actually helped to keep recycling that ball and not giving away the possession, as Naz says. So I think what we had a chance to see was just, I don't know if it was a mind transference. You know, we saw last season the 45 to 60 minutes was the, you know, tight time when you thought Chelsea were always going to give away a goal. And we kind of navigated through, Nick, that post, you know, halftime moment where we've seen a lot of crumbling previously. And, you know, I think Christensen, Zuma, Emerson, Azpilicueta all really stepped up to be a better unit in the second half than they were together in the first half.
Yeah, I mean, the team, you know, we talked about the space in between, you know, the specific units last week as a huge problem, right? You know, we were giving Leicester all the time in the world to get past our midfield and attack our back four and sometimes our back three, depending on how high up the field Emerson was at any given time. So that was a huge difference to me. They stayed tighter. You know, the units stayed tighter. You saw Tammy dropping deep sometimes to help defend a little bit and then would get back up. You know, we're talking about a second half in which I think Emerson was outstanding again. You know, there's a strong argument to be made that it's him and Mason Mount this year as Chelsea's potential players of the year so far. you know, I thought he was just outstanding and has played a huge role so far. So just, you know, really happy for him. But yeah, I mean, it's also, you don't have to press like crazy people all the time. And I think Frank is probably employing some different tactics, which is good because we thought that was going to be a huge benefit of his reign as manager, that we can play different styles and still, you know, kind of figure out a way to get it done. And yeah, I think it was a much more controlling, conservative, less crazy pressing second half, and that's totally fine.
Yeah, I think that's important. I think crazy is the right word in a way, because there's almost the Man United game that was 4-0. It could have gone either way, of course, but you know, when you go crazy, then you're basically opening up any possible result, and you're not controlling the result, you're not controlling the game. And when you play a team like Norwich especially, you're better than them. So to do that, to keep the ball, that just shows your dominance, and Chelsea is Chelsea Football Club, and that's what they need to do. But yeah, they still conceded two goals, and it was exactly the same problem as Leicester. Buendia, a very good playmaker for Norwich, I thought he was excellent, and he assisted both goals, and it was just finding that space in between the two lines. It's everyone's kind of, you know, you look on social media and people are blaming Kurt Zouma. You know, he might have been at fault maybe for the second goal, but they're blaming this guy, that guy, whoever, Jorginho. But really, it's a more tactical issue because, like you said, there's too much space between the lines, and it's not individual defensive issues. It's finding that final ball that's killing Chelsea. Teams are being able to do it too often, and it hurts them.
You know, if you just go back to the stats again, and maybe I'll pop up on who scored, just to kind of see the trends that they had in this match. I mean, the amount of possession and chances that Chelsea had. But again, I just thought that Norwich just stepped to so many of our shots. We didn't even get a chance to test the keeper, sadly. And I felt like that was something that they did so much better than us, as you kind of talk about Zouma Christensen there, Naz. But just kind of the way it developed, I think you're right. Chelsea were very patient. They were very methodical in the second half of continuing to keep possession. But also, I think last season, you would have seen Maritza, it would have been very horizontal, back and forth. You know, we got the ball to the 18-yard box, and then we'd stand there. And then we'd hope that, you know, we'd essentially cycle it to the other side. And teams would just block in the box because they knew we didn't have an option.
Yeah.
Like, the ability to get vertical quicker in this match, to me, is just so much of a... just so much of a better characteristic. They know that, yes, there's times we should switch the play and possess, but there's also times we can hit that killer ball and get in behind. And I thought that was just great to see the team do it. You know, even in the second half, when Norwich is defending with so many players, they were still able to create some opportunities and get a bunch of shots off. I mean, I don't know, because I didn't watch the stats that closely that season, but when is the last time under Maurizio Sarri, if ever, did we have 23 shots in a match? To me, that wasn't the way we played last season.
No, it's a lot quicker, definitely. And you're right. Everything you said there is what Lampard's trying to achieve. And the difference between Sarri and Lampard is that, you know, there's way more freedom as well from the forwards. They can do what they want a little bit more. Whereas Sarri, it was methodical and teams worked it out. They worked out what he was trying to do. So yeah, I mean, you know, Pulisic can do something completely random that throws a team off or drags two players out of position, things like that. So it's great to see. But I think that, you know, another thing I wanted to do is just praise, you know, for the control of the game, which is sort of the original point, was that which sort of four players would you say control the game? It's the two centre-backs and, you know, two central midfielders who sit deepest, which probably Kovacic and Jorginho. They deserve a lot of credit for the way they played. I thought Kovacic was excellent. He got picked out on TV as having a great game as well. And Zouma won 100% of his battles. Christensen, very controlled, great in possession as well. And Barkley as well was really good in possession. Probably could have done better with his sort of shots. But otherwise, you know, it's sort of, you know, a pretty complete performance from the spine of the team. And the great Chelsea teams that Frank Lampard played in, they had a solid spine, absolutely rock solid. And, you know, if you have that central area of the pitch locked down for both possession and winning battles, then it makes these kind of games so much easier.